Get your dream job with Chennai Race Institute. Study the following information carefully and answer the questions given below. 8 persons J, K, T, R, N, Y, P and V are sitting in a row. Some of them facing north and some of them facing south, but not necessarily in the same order. T sits second to the right of N. K sits immediate right of T. Two persons sit between K and V. R sits second to the right of V. There are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. Y does not sit at any of the extreme end. K and R are facing opposite direction. Immediate neighbors of V face same direction. Persons sitting at the extreme ends face same direction. K is not facing north. Y and J are facing opposite direction. N sits at one of the extreme end. T does not sit immediate left of K. V and J are not sitting immediately next to each other. Let's draw the diagram based on the information. 8 persons J, K, T, R, N, Y, P and V are sitting in a row. Here some of them facing north and some of them facing south, but not necessarily in the same order. First, choose the best statement to solve the problem. Here one of the statement is, N sits at one of the extreme end. This is the best statement to solve this problem easily. So skip all the statements before this statements. Later we will discuss. In diagram, here the extreme ends are this position and this position. So we can place N here or here, because from the given statement, N sits at one of the extreme end. So we will get two possible diagrams, diagram 1 and diagram 2. In diagram 1, place N here and we don't know the direction of N. Here N sits at one of the extreme end. In diagram 2, place N here and we don't know the direction of N. Here N sits at one of the extreme end. Go to the next statement. T sits second to the right of N. Here in diagram 1, N sits here. We can place T here or here, but we can't place T here because there is no position before N. So place T here only. Here N faces north direction because T sits second to the right of N. Here in diagram 2, N sits here. We can place T here or here, but we can't place T here because there is no position before N. So place T here only. Here N faces south direction because T sits second to the right of N. Go to the next statement. K sits immediate right of T. Here in diagram 1, T sits here and we don't know the direction of T. So we can place K here or here because K sits immediate right of T. So we will get two possible diagrams, diagram 1A and diagram 1B. In diagram 1A, T sits here and faces south direction. So place K here only because K sits immediate right of T. In diagram 1B, here T sits here and faces north direction. So place K here only because K sits immediate right of T. Here in diagram 2, T sits here and we don't know the direction of T. So we can place K here or here because K sits immediate right of T. So we will get two possible diagrams. diagram 2A and diagram 2B. In diagram 2A, T sits here and faces north direction. So place K here only because K sits immediate right of T. In diagram 2B, here T sits here and faces south direction. So place K here only because K sits immediate right of T. Go to the next statement. K is not facing north. Here in diagram 1A, K sits here. From the given statement, K is not facing north. It means K faces south direction. Here K is not facing north. Here in diagram 1B, K sits here. From the given statement, K is not facing north. It means K faces south direction. Here K is not facing north. Here in diagram 2A, K sits here. From the given statement, K is not facing north. It means K faces south direction. Here K is not facing north. Here in diagram 2B, K sits here. From the given statement, K is not facing north. It means K faces south direction. Here K is not facing north. Go to the next statement. T does not sit immediate left of K. In diagram 1A, K sits here and faces south direction and T sits here. Here T sits immediate left of K. So cancel this diagram. In diagram 1B, K sits here and faces south direction and T sits here. Here T sits immediate right of K. So T does not sit immediate left of K. Here in diagram 2A, K sits here and faces south direction and T sits here. Here T sits immediate right of K. So T does not sit immediate left of K. Here in diagram 2B, K sits here and faces south direction and T sits here. Here T sits immediate left of K. So cancel this diagram. And go to the next statement. Two persons sit between K and V. Here in diagram 1B, K sits here. So we can place V here or here, but we can't place V here because this position is already filled with N. So, place V here only because two persons sit between K and V. Here in diagram 2A, K sits here. So, we can place V here or here, but we can't place V here because here there is only one position after K. So, place V here only because two persons sit between K and V. Go to the next statement. R sits second to the right of V. Here in diagram 1B, V sits here. So we can place R here or here, but we can't place R here because there is no second position after V. So place R here only. Here V faces south direction because R sits second to the right of V. Here in diagram 2A, V sits here. So we can place R here or here, but we can't place R here because this position is already filled with T. So place R here only. Here V faces south direction because R sits second to the right of V. Go to the next statement. There are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. Here in diagram 1B, T sits here and R sits here. Here only one person sits in between T and R. From the given statement, there are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. It means only one person sits in between Y and P. Here we can place Y or P here or here or here. If we can place Y here, so we have to place P here, but we can't place P here because this position is already filled with K. So we can place Y or P here or here only. And in the next statement, they also given that Y does not sit at any of the extreme end. So we can't place Y in this position. So place Y here and P here only. Here, there are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. In diagram 2A, T sits here and R sits here. Here, three persons sits in between T and R. From the given statement, there are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. It means only three persons sits in between Y and P. Here we can place Y or P here or here because three persons sits in between Y and P. So we can place Y or P here or here. And in the next statement, they also given that Y does not sit at any of the extreme ends. So we can't place Y here. It means place Y here and P here only. Here, there are as many persons sit between T and R as between Y and P. Fill the remaining position with remaining person with J. Go to the next statement. V and J are not sitting immediately next to each other. In diagram 1B, V sits here, J sits here. Here V and J are not sitting immediately next to each other. In diagram 2A, V sits here, J sits here. Here, V and J are sitting immediately next to each other. So, cancel this diagram. Go to the next statement. K and R are facing opposite direction. Here in diagram 1B, K sits here and faces south direction. And R sits here and must face north direction. Because K and R are facing opposite direction. Go to next statement. Persons sitting at the extreme ends face same direction. Here in diagram 1B, person sitting at the extreme ends are N and P. N sits here and faces north direction. And P sits here and must faces north direction. Because persons sitting at the extreme ends face same direction. Go to the next statement. Immediate neighbors of V face same direction. Here in diagram 1B, immediate neighbors of V are Y and P. P sits here and faces north direction. And Y sits here and must face north direction only. Because immediate neighbors of V face same direction. Go to the next statement. Y and J are facing opposite direction. Here in diagram 1B, Y sits here and faces north direction. And J sits here and must faces south direction. Because Y and J are facing opposite direction. And this is the final diagram. Let's see the questions on this diagram. Question number 1. How many persons are facing north? Options are option A, 2, option B, 3, option C, 5, option D, 4, and option E. None of these. Now let's see the solution. Here in diagram, N, T, R, Y, and P faces north direction. So here, 5 persons are facing north direction. So the answer is option C, 5. Question number 2. Who among the following person sits fourth to the left of J? Options are option A, V, option B, P, option C, K, option D, Y, and option E. None of these. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, person sit fourth to the left of J is Y. So the answer is option D, Y. Question number 3. 4 of the following 5 are alike in a certain way based on the arrangement and hence form a group. Which one of the following does not belong to the group? Options are option A, N, option B, Y, option C, J, option D, T, and option E, R. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, N, Y, T, and R faces north direction and J facing south direction. So except J, all R faces north direction and J faces south direction. So the answer is option C, J. Question number 4. Who among the following person sits third to the right of Y? Options are option A, T, option B, no one, option C, J, option D, K, and option E. None of these. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, Y sits here and no one sits third to the right of Y. So the answer is option B, no one. Question number 5. Who among the following person sits exactly between N and T? Options are option A, J, option B, K, option C, Y, option D, V, and option E. None of these. Let's see the solution. Here in diagram, N sits here and T sits here. So person sits exactly between N and T is J. So the answer is option A, J. Join today in Chennai Race Institute and learn from the experts. Thanks for watching.